Hello everyone, I am Bob and this is the Home Bitcoin Immersion Mining channel. In this design series episode, I'm going to show you how to master auto-tuning and dynamic performance scaling to improve the operation of your miners. So with that, let's get started. But before getting started, I just want to mention the sponsors of this episode, starting with Brains and their mining monitoring tools. As you stack your sats through home mining, you'll want to monitor the performance of your miners to ensure everything is working well. And the Brains Pool dashboard and Brains app are the perfect tools for staying on top of your miner performance. You can monitor your overall hash rate, miner status, current sats accumulated, and upcoming payouts. You can also set up notifications to alert you when miners go offline or start to underperform. And with the Brains mobile app linked to your pool account, you can monitor all of this on the go. This is just another one of the great tools the Brains ecosystem has available for you to make the most of your home mining setup. Now my next sponsor is Scott's Crypto Mining and the Build-A-Mine Bootcamp. In the Build-A-Mine Bootcamp, you'll learn everything you need to know to launch your first megawatt of Bitcoin miners in less than 3 months. The Build-A-Mine Bootcamp is taught by Scott himself, and you'll be joined by other entrepreneurs and business owners like you who want to learn how to stack more sats faster through Bitcoin mining on an industrial scale. To get in on this fantastic opportunity, just click the link in the description below. Okay, so as I've noted in past episodes, it's really a great idea to operate your miners with custom firmware, such as Brains OS Plus, because these aftermarket firmwares have two really important features that enable you to maximize your miner operation. And those features are auto-tuning and dynamic performance scaling. Both of these features are extremely useful whether you are operating with air cooling or with immersion cooling. And in this episode, I'm going to show you how to get these two capabilities to work together for any type of mining setup. So as I've noted in a previous episode, auto-tuning ensures that the individual ASIC chips in your miners are operating at the most efficient speed for a given power level. Now, when it comes to picking out power levels for optimization, you can just pick a single level and optimize there. But in reality, whether you're operating your miner in an immersion setup or with air cooling, the heat generated by the miners has to be dissipated and sent somewhere. That usually is either the ambient environment or some sort of home heating or other use of the mining heat. And most of these heat sinks are not constant over time. For example, if you're exhausting heat to the ambient environment, the temperature changes throughout the day and throughout the year. And if you're using the mining heat to heat your home, the amount of heat needed can also fluctuate quite a bit. This means that whether you are using immersion or air cooling, you should expect your miner to operate at a range of different temperatures with a corresponding range of power levels. So when you set up your miner, it's a better idea to take the time to auto-tune your miners at many different power levels, creating a complete mapping of optimal chip operation. And the way this works is to start at the lowest power level you'd ever think of running your miner, say 2000 watts, and then let the firmware run its optimization sequence to find the optimal configuration at that power level. Once that optimized configuration is found, increment the power level by a small amount, say 200 to 500 watts, and then re-optimize. Repeat this all the way up to the maximum safe power level you think you might want to run your miner, say 4,000 watts or so. Now this might take a lot of time. The first optimization alone could take 6 hours or longer, so be patient here. Also, at higher power levels, you might really be stressing your cooling system, so you might have to wait for a really cold day, or you might have to turn off other miners to provide enough cooling capacity for the miner being optimized. But after this is complete, the OS firmware will have a complete mapping of optimized configuration stored for your miner, so that anytime you run your miner at any of these power levels, you will be able to run with an optimized configuration. And before I get into how this works with dynamic power scaling, I just want to remind you to like, subscribe, share, and comment below. Even a quick comment below stating you've enjoyed this video will tell that YouTube algorithm to share this content with more people like you. Now, with auto-tuning of your miner completed, the next step is to set up dynamic performance scaling. Now, I'm going to describe how this works with the Brains OS Plus firmware, since that's what I'm using in my setup. If you're using another firmware, you'll have to consult their information on how to configure performance scaling with that software. But when it comes to the Brains OS Plus firmware, the way dynamic performance scaling works is you specify a power target, a power step, and a hot temperature limit for each miner. The power target is the power level the miner will attempt to maintain. The power step is the size of power adjustments the firmware is allowed to make. And the hot temperature limit is the upper temperature allowed for miner operation. Now, when the miner is running normally, the firmware will attempt to run the miner at that power target level. But if while attempting to maintain this power level, the miner starts to heat up and the miner temperature gets hot enough to hit that hot temperature limit, the dynamic performance scaling will automatically decrease the miner power by that power step increment. If the miner then continues to heat up and hits this hot temperature limit again, the miner power will be decreased by another power step increment. This process will continue, and dynamic performance scaling will reduce the miner power as needed to maintain power temperatures underneath that hot temperature limit. Now, conversely, if the heat loss from the miner increases and the temperature of the miner drops 5 degrees C below that hot temperature limit, dynamic performance scaling will increase the miner power by that power step interval. If the heat draw from the miner continues and the temperature of the miner drops another 5 degrees below that hot temperature limit, the dynamic performance scaling will increase the power by another power step interval. This process will continue, and dynamic performance scaling will increase miner power until the miner operation returns to that power target level. Okay, so with auto-tuning and dynamic performance scaling each described separately, how do these two features work together? Well, when dynamic performance scaling is set up, all you have to do is to set the power target to one of those auto-tuned power levels and to set the power step value equal to the separation between your auto-tuned power levels. This way, as the dynamic performance scaling steps the power of your miners up and down, it will always land on an optimized power level so that you're always getting the best performance out of your miners. And for a real-life example of how this works, I'm using auto-tuning and dynamic performance scaling together in my home mining setup. As I've noted in my build series episodes, I've built my mining setup to heat my home, and during winter here in Colorado, we can see fairly large temperature differences throughout the day, with swings as large as 50 degrees Fahrenheit being fairly common. In addition, we have a lot of sunny days, and the added solar heating effect on my home is fairly strong. So in a fairly typical winter day, I can go from early morning where my miners are heavily overclocked and struggle to provide enough heat to late afternoon where my dry cooler can only handle the normal power levels. So the way I've set up my miners is first I ran auto-tuning at power levels starting at 1800 watts. I auto-tuned at 200 watt increments all the way up to 4800 watts. Now at these higher power levels, there are a few important notes to make. First, I'm operating my miners in an immersion setup and well above their rated power levels. And Bitmain makes it very clear that if my miner or PSU goes down, the warranty is voided. Second, the power levels shown in the Brains OS Plus firmware are significantly lower than the real power levels as measured at my miner. For example, at the 4800 watt setting, my miner is only pulling about 4400 watts at the wall, which is about as high as you ever want to push a stock PSU. Finally, when I was auto-tuning a miner at these higher levels, I had to run my other miner at a very low power level so that the combined heat wasn't overloading my dry cooler system. Now, this took a few days to get each miner fully tuned. I could have picked a larger power step size, like 250 or 500 watts, to make this go a lot faster, but I had the time, and I think it's just kind of fun to play with my mining setup. With auto-tuning done, the next step was to set up my dynamic performance scaling. Now, I want to make sure my home gets all of the power it needs, so I set my power target at the maximum power level I tune my miners, which is 4800 watts. I then set my power step equal to my tuning increments of 200 watts. What that means is that dynamic performance scaling will pump up the miner power whenever it can, always trying to run my miners at the highest power level. Now, this could be dangerous since in the middle of a sunny afternoon, my home will not need that heat and my dry cooler can't provide enough cooling at these high power levels. My miners would definitely overheat and might get permanently damaged, but this is where the hot temperature limit comes in. During winter operation, I set my hot temperature limit to only 77 degrees C. Now, this is pretty low. In an immersion setup, you can usually run a miner at temperatures higher than 80 degrees C without a problem. But my goal here is to protect my miners and only run them at higher power levels when there is a matching heat draw. So to walk you through how all of this works on a typical day, starting in the middle of the night, it's very cold outside, and my home will start pulling a ton of heat from my mining setup. With this heat loss, the temperature of my miners will start to drop, and when they hit 5 degrees below that hot temperature limit, the dynamic performance scaling will kick in and bump up the power to my next auto-tune level. The temperature of my miners might decrease a little, but if my home still needs more heat and keeps that miner temperature 5 degrees below that hot temperature limit, the dynamic performance scaling will again bump up the power. This continues until the exact amount of heat needed to heat my home is met by the power level of my miners. And at that point, the dynamic performance scaling will hold the power levels of my miners constant. Now, later in the day, when the sun comes out and my home doesn't need as much heat, my miners, still operating at these higher power levels, will start to heat up and will eventually hit that hot temperature limit. Now, because I set this at only 77 degrees, this temperature isn't damaging the miners. But when this temperature limit is hit, it signals the dynamic performance scaling to cut back the miner power down to that next auto-tuned level. The temperature of my miners might decrease a bit, but if my home continues to heat up and needs less heat, and the temperature of my miners again hits that hot temperature limit, the dynamic performance scaling will again kick in and bump down the power lower. This will continue to turn down the power to my miners so they stay within safe temperature levels as the power is ramped down to a level my dry coolers can handle. And so, taking all of this together, my mining setup is automatically load following my home heat demands throughout the day. When my home needs more heat, the miner power ramps up to meet that demand, and when my home needs less heat, the miners are ramped down to normal levels my dry cooler system can handle. This is being done continuously and completely automatically by the miner firmware, and once this was set up and turned on, I haven't had to touch a thing, and I think that's pretty cool. Now, when the seasons change and I don't need to heat my house, I can reconfigure dynamic performance scaling to focus on mining efficiency through the summer. But this video is getting a bit long, and I want to get through a few summer months before I cover that configuration, so I'm not going to cover that here. If you're interested in an episode covering that kind of configuration, leave a comment below and I'll find some time in a future episode to fit it in. Okay, so that's all I've got for this episode, and if you want to learn more about how my dry coolers are automatically turning on and off throughout these daily temperature swings, here's a video where I cover that design. Like, subscribe so you don't miss any new episodes coming your way, and with that, bye!